Hey everybody, nice cool day in Florida today. I got some really awesome upgrades to tell you about. Start off with this high pipe. Tell you something that freaked me out. I didn't know that they come with a flat spot on it, and it looks like they've been bent. I was so pissed. And I guess they make that for clearance, because I've talked to some people and went online and looked. And they're all like that. That was a huge relief. It was really tight putting it on. Not much clearance. Anyway, it's on. Looks good. And I'll tell you what a reason I did that. I've had my Jeep gas engines always underwater. Get them hydrolocked, you pull a spark plug, and spit the water out, no problem. These diesels, I don't really know how to get the water out of them. I tried to research it, but my best theory was to put this pipe on, and if it shut off while I'm underwater, kind of saves me from getting any water back in the engine. If it the exhaust valve happened to stay open when it shut down or something like that. All right, upgrade number two is, bam, how about that? What? Yes, right, got a tag. Taking them stupid reverse lights tag light off, that didn't do anything for me. Don't you want to know how I did that? I've been advised not to really tell you, but I think that's kind of a jerk move. I'll give you a hint. You got to have a title from GovPlanet and see your local tax collector office and go from there. And good luck, because it was a long journey. It's on the road, insured, and tagged. Right now I'm working with my batteries. There's my fuse block I told you guys about in another video. But I've been running my front and rear winch hookups off this back battery. And for some reason, when it charges, the alternator's on, it charges this one right off the bat. Bumps this up pretty quick. And I thought they would equalize because they're connected. That's not the case. This battery's been slowly draining down, and I don't know if that's an alternate problem. But I'm just gonna hook everything up on the front battery, and hopefully that will fix my problem there. That's it. The tag was the best news. The flags, they go on the back. I just got them sitting there right now. Pretty cool. But yeah, can't wait to get out on the road. And I found out a little bit about the display only or whatever. As long as you keep it military, you're out for public display. You're displaying a military vehicle. They just don't want you painting it red or something, doing no chrome rims or something ridiculous. But yeah, as long as you keep the military look, you're good to go. All right. Hope I helped you guys out there. Out.